Hi there, we have this gallery right here with a header and everything is just adapting to the width and height of the screen that's inside. So it's a very flexible gallery inside Power Apps that we learned how to do in the previous lessons in this playlist. Now we want to do one adjustment, that is when the screen has a smaller width. At a certain point, we want to decrease the size of the letters inside the labels. So we want to have a smaller font size. How can we do that? Okay, let's take a look at one property here that has the size of the screen. Okay, I'm going to insert a label. And here in this label, I'm going to put this information, app.activeScreen.size. Okay, we have one number here that represents the size of the screen that's currently showing, the active screen. See, we have the app, that's the whole app that's playing, it's one property we can access. Then we have the active screen, and that's a control with several properties inside it. We can get the current screen name, for example, and we can get the size of the screen. Right now it's showing 4. What does it mean? Okay, let's play the app and see what happens. Right now, the size of the current screen is 4. If I decrease the size, the width, for example, right now it's showing 3. See, it's showing 3. If I decrease more, at certain point, will show 2. And then, if I go even more, it will show 1. So, 1 stands for small, 2, medium, 3, large, and 4, extra large. Basically, what's happening here is that Power Apps detects the size of the browser or the device, and then informs through this property what's the current size. Okay, so in this case, I'm using an extra large screen. If I decrease more, let's say it's a tablet, it's a large. If it's a smartphone, it's a small screen. Okay, one point of attention is that if we use this in the play mode, this function here that selects the tablet, for example, we can see as a tablet or we can see as a phone. It doesn't actually change that number. Not working here, it's not showing, but it will take the last number that was in there and it won't change. It needs to be the window size or the canvas size to work properly. I've tested before and, for example, right now. So let's put 1 and then change to a tablet. It's still 1 showing there. See, it didn't change even though a tablet is a 3 or a 4. So right now it's not working. Maybe in the future, Microsoft has solved that. Okay, so if you keep changing here, that number you cannot trust right now. Okay, if you want to really test for a device that changes size, you need to keep in the window size and then just resize here. Or there is this other option that's right click, go to inspect, and in the browser features, we have one place here where we can simulate device sizes. If I click here, for example, and choose to be the dimension of an iPhone, then it will detect and show us an iPhone dimension. But that one inside Power Apps right now is not working, okay? Right, so what can we do with these sizes? Well, we can put a condition in the font size of the labels based on this size, based on the screen size. So we'll select all the labels inside the gallery, and in the font size, I will do the following. If app.activeScreen.size it's bigger than 2, it means if it's a 3 or a 4, if it's a large or an extra large, then the font size will be 13. Otherwise, it will be 11, let's say. So I'm going to close the parentheses, hit play. Right now it's 4, so for 4 or 3, it will be 13. Once I start changing and it becomes a 2, it will go to 11. So I will keep decreasing until it gets to a number 2. See, it's 2. We can see that the font size is just decreased. If I go a little bit wider and go back to 3, then we have a bigger font size. So for smaller screens, now it's adapting and it's decreasing the font size and looking better. We can do this also for the headers. So let's go copy the formula we put in the label, select all the headers. I'm pressing Ctrl and clicking, and then go to the font size and paste the formula. Okay, now let's see again, it's working. Okay, let me just, so now it's 11, because it's number 2 here, the screen size is number 2. And then we can increase until number 3, and the fonts will increase together with the size of the screen. Okay, we could improve the formula even more. If we wanted, for example, for a screen size number 1, we could put, for example, that the font will be 9. So let's say another condition here in the if the screen size is equal to, then it's 11. And the last condition, if it's not bigger than 2, if it's not 2, it will be 9. If you have any questions about how to use the if function like this, I have also a video on my channel where I explain. If I remember, I'll put here in the description or in the first comment the link to that video. Okay, now for smaller screen size, the size small number 1 will have a small font. So let's see, let's go until the number 1. See, the headers just have very small fonts now. Font size 9. Let's also put this formula now in these labels inside the gallery, and we will be done with this configuration. So I'm just copying this formula, selecting all the labels inside the gallery, and pasting it in the size property. Okay, let's play. And decrease the size here, so we have size in number 1, the font is 9, number 2, the font is 11, number 3 or 4, the font will be 13, so very, very nice. Okay, what defines the size? So when it is a small screen, when it's a medium, when it's a large, and when it's a extra large. There is one property here inside the app. If we go to the tree view here in the app, we have this property called size breakpoints. So here we have 3 size breakpoints. It means smaller than the first one, smaller than 600 is small. Between 600 and 900 pixels is medium. Between 900 and 300 is large, the number 3. And greater than 1200 is extra large, the number 4. And we can change these numbers. In the other screen, I have created something for us to visualize better how it works. So right now, this shows the areas where the sizes apply. So here is 600 pixels. It means before this position, this width is number 1, that's small. If it's between 600, that's in this position here, and 900, that's this position here, between these two points, it's size number 2. Between 900 and 1200, it's large, so it's number 3. And after 1200 is number 4. And I could change in the configurations, and this size would change in the app. if I just resize here, we can see it working. So for example, now that we have this width is number 4. But if I decrease and get to the area that's green, it's the size 0.3. So current size is 3. If I go to the 2, if I keep making it narrow, we will reach the red area, so current size is 2. If I go to the app properties and change it, it will change how the app behaves and how it recognizes the different sizes. This is the default, but I could have changed to, let's say, 400. And then 800 and 1200. Now all the ranges are the same of 400, and I can see that it's changed, and now the app will respect this configuration. So for example, let's go to the wider one. If now I keep changing the width of the browser, it will use those values to determine what's the size of the screen, and this will apply to the formulas that we used in that gallery. You can use the default one, but now you know that if you need to change for some reason, it's located in the size breakpoints properties of the app. We are ready with our gallery regarding sizes and positions. Now there is one last adjustment. That's when we have a small width. We don't want the gallery to keep shrinking. We want to stop at some point, and then we want to show a scroll bar in the bottom. So I'm going to show you in the next video how we can have a scroll bar when the gallery is wider than the screen or the container that it's inside. Please share your thoughts in the comments, because that helps me a lot to prepare the next classes. So I see you in the next class.